What is going on, guys? Tech Titanium here, and in today's video, I'm going to be going against majority of the ones you'll find about optimizing Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2, because I'm just simply sick of seeing the same shit about this game all over my feed, over and over and over again. The initial intent of this video was to highlight Nvidia Reflex, Nvidia Control Panel, Windows settings, and of course, some recommendations that we could all find online. I've decided to push it even further by benchmarking each individual Call of Duty setting to come up with an overall setting of high FPS and a great visual looking game. Now keep in mind when watching this video, my overall system latency does not include that of my monitor or my mouse, as I simply don't have a compatible mouse to give us those numbers. But regardless, you're going to see the exact effect that Nvidia Reflex has to give us a competitive edge over other gamers in all the games that we play that of course support Nvidia Reflex. As many of you, I also followed these guides to help better increase my performance, but soon came to realize that a lot of these guys simply don't know what they're talking about, and the effects that they're telling us to do just simply do not do anything. And I'm going to go ahead and show you my system settings. Game mode, I've left this on. Graphics, change default graphics settings. The only one that I've kept off is hardware accelerated GPU scheduling, as it did some weird shit to Modern Warfare in particular, so I've kept this off. It also decreased my FPS, just in case you were wondering. Nvidia control panel, as you can see here, these are pretty much what it looks like at default settings, and the only ones I've changed were the Nvidia low latency mode, which is set to ultra, geared towards my specific PC, and same thing with the program settings. These are all default except for the low latency. My power management is set to normal, highest available for the refresh rate, and I've selected my graphics card. Alright guys, so let's go ahead, go to Call of Duty in your documents, players, and let's talk about options.3.cod22. And I'm going to go ahead and say it, leave this at default, because every change that you make in-game is going to affect what you see in this section. And I've done it, Warzone 1, I've halved my cores, I saw no improvement. And the same thing applies to this game. And even if I wanted to, follow a guide on YouTube and says put the total amount of cores of your system in this section, well, I simply can't because I have 24 cores on my CPU. And even if I tried to set this to 24, you guessed it, it automatically defaults back to 16. So this section is completely useless in my honest opinion, because if I had to do this for a game, I just simply wouldn't buy it. And I haven't been touching that folder since last year, and the effects are no different today. And I'm not going to recommend the settings to you guys, but you feel free to try what I'm about to show you, because you're going to see I'm attaining high FPS while having a great visually looking game at the same time. And that's all I wanted to say. I hope you guys enjoy these next clips, because it took me a long time to put all this together. So I hope you appreciate it. And actually, you know, like I said, if you want to try these settings out, go ahead. I've tried this on a 10700KF paired with a 3060, a 10900K paired with a 3080, and a 13900K paired with a 4080, and the settings were the same across the board. Now the FPS number was not, of course, because they're three totally different graphics cards. And that's what I'm trying to get across to you guys. None of us have an even playing ground because we all have different components to our computer. So just keep this in mind the next time you decide to follow a Call of Duty Warzone optimization guide, because simply put, it's just not going to work the same way that it does on my system that it does on yours.
journey. We are taking journey.
Alright guys, so let's go ahead and get some in-game footage, and we're going to see what Nvidia Reflex actually does. Right now with it off, I'm sitting at about 12.5 to 14.2 milliseconds, and when it comes to FPS shooters, Call of Duty, or anything else, we want to have every possible advantage when it comes to other players. One of the ways to do this is by decreasing your system latency, otherwise known as input lag. Something as simple as flicking your mouse across the screen, clicking your mouse button, and actually getting your shots across does matter when it comes to online gaming. So if we can reduce this in any way that we can, especially in a game like Call of Duty, which is not optimized well, we're going to take everything we can get. By setting this to on, the overall system latency drops to 10.5 milliseconds, which is basically a 2 millisecond improvement. And with on plus boost, this drops to as low as 9. So we're going to take everything we can get and hopefully improve our in-game gameplay. So the game seems to be taking well to these changes. The best way that I can try and describe it is when I move the mouse, it snaps into place rather than having this gradual smoothness to it, if that makes sense. But nevertheless, we've decreased the overall system latency, or in other words, input lag, and that's what we want. We're trying to get a better responsiveness in game to give us that edge over other players. And what I'm going to do next is try and get the GPU time closer to the CPU time, to have them essentially be in sync with one another. And if you're in a case where your CPU time is higher than your GPU time, all that means is that your graphics card is waiting for your processor to do what it needs to do before it queues the next frames. So essentially you're bottlenecked by your CPU, and the only effective way that I can think of to better your chances at lowering that number is to overclock your CPU if it's capable of doing so. But that's a whole other topic, and I'm not going to get too much into that. But if you are in that boat, try that first before trying to upgrade your system. So to lower this number of the GPU time, I'm just lowering the in-game graphics settings, because we're essentially lightening the load of the GPU. So this is going to give us more frames, and in return, a lower millisecond response time. And as you can see, it's lowered to 4. So I'm going to go ahead now, just for video's sake, I'm going to drop the settings to the bare minimum. And just make sure that if you are using these settings, to set your render resolution back to 100. And for full effect, I'm going to reboot the game because we need to reinitialize the shaders. Alright guys, so I'm booted back into the game, and as you can see, our CPU and GPU times are now pretty much in sync. I'm also getting 300 FPS, and the one thing I noticed right off the bat is it feels much faster, of course, because there's more frames being pumped into our view, essentially. But the only issue that I can see with this is potential screen tearing, as my monitor is only capable of 240 Hz. So if I do come across this, I'm going to do some more testing, but I might have to just dial the graphics settings a little bit. But nevertheless, we're in the low sevens in terms of system latency. So you can see by increasing the frames, by lowering the graphics settings, we're getting an even much lower number. And this is, like I said, what we're after. We're after that ultimate gaming advantage over other players. And this is just one of those ways to do so. Alright guys, so next I'm going to give you some actual in-game multiplayer footage just to showcase my settings and the actual FPS that I'm squeezing out of my GPU. So I, for my PC, achieved the highest amount of frames as I possibly could while making the game look absolutely stunning, because I didn't want to just drop down to bare minimum and have the game look like trash just to achieve 297 frames on average. And I know, as much as we like certain YouTubers and streamers, don't always believe what you see on the internet, guys. You gotta test these things out for yourselves, as I did, which is why I created this video for you guys, so you could see that on my specific system, I was able to achieve my end goal. So if you guys did like the video, please drop me a like, give me a comment if you do decide to try these settings. And of course, if you want to see future content, please subscribe to this channel. I also want to apologize in advance because I forgot to turn off my microphone while recording the gameplay footage for you guys, so you're going to hear the mouse and keyboard in the background. But other than that, like I said, have a good one. Take it easy.
Close air. Target marked.
Solid copy. Longbow 31 on station.
Request the fire mission. Target marked.
Mortar strike inbound now.
Target down!